Namaste children, how are you? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. I am also good here. So today's class is about our nature. So before starting the session, I would like to ask you a few questions. Do you love our nature? And have you heard about the natural disasters? Have you experienced natural disasters? Have you heard about tsunami and what are the causes of tsunami? So let's see the inspiring stories of the characters, how they met tsunami and how they safeguarded themselves from the natural disaster. Shall we go and see? Yes. The topic of the lesson is tsunami. So what is a tsunami? Tsunami is a giant wave caused by earthquakes or volcanic eruption under the sea. They speed along as fosters jet planes. So here is a video. You all have to know where the tsunami happened on December 26, 2004. After that, I am going to tell you an inspiring story about different characters of this legend. Here is a video. The lesson deals with the inspiring incidents that took place when the tsunami hit the different parts of the world. The first part includes stories from the Andaman and Nicobar Island. The first story is of Ignatius. He was the manager of cooperative society in Kutchal Island. At around 6 a.m., his wife woke him up, sensing that something is going to happen wrong. That's earthquake. He put the television set on the floor in order to save it while the family rushed out of the house. When the earth stopped shaking, they could see the sea rising. The tsunami swept his wife, two children, father-in-law and brother-in-law. And second is, the story is about a policeman, Sanjeev. He was able to save himself, his wife and his daughter. But after hearing the cries of the guest house cook John's wife, he jumped into the water in order to save her. He could not save her as well as himself and both got drowned. The third story is about the 13-year-old girl Meghna. The tsunami swept her along with her parents and 77 other people. But fortunately, she held on to a wooden door. After floating for 2 days, a wave brought her back to the shore and saved her. The last story is about Almas Javed, a 10-year-old girl. Her father saw the water receding after the tremors and understood that it will come back with immense force. He thus woke everybody so that they can go to a safer place. So in all this chaos and confusion, her grandfather fell down and her father went to help him. Something hit in her grandfather's head. That's why Alma Javed's father went and helped him up. A big wave swept them away during this time. Her mother and aunts swept away along with the tree. Especially it's a coconut tree. You know how the coconut tree leaves would be. They were holding on to, but they were also swept away in the water. While Almas climbed on a floating wooden log and fainted, she was taken to the hospital in Kamurta. The second part of the chapter consists of a story from Thailand. Actually, this is the story of an intelligent girl, Chilli Smith. It was 26 December and Chilli along with her family were on the beach. Chilli and her family were originally from England and they came to Thailand to celebrate Christmas. Chilli and her mother saw the sea rising slowly, start to foam and making whirlpools. Her mother was not worried by these signs, but it occurred to Chilli that these signs were the signs of tsunami. She learned everything from her classroom. Her teacher taught that how the tsunami will come and how to safeguard themselves. So she informed about this to her family and they along with other people on the beach returned to the hotel. Luckily, the hotel building withstood the force of tsunami and they all were saved because of Chilli Smith's knowledge. The third part of the story is about the sixth sense of the animals. As you all know very well how the animals would be. Do they have sensing ability?
Do you think that they have the sensing power to feel the disasters? Yes, here is a story. Around 150,000 people lost their lives, but only a few animals died. For example, in the Ayala National Park situated in Sri Lanka, nearly 60 visitors died while only 2 animals died. See, actually, when they were in Patanagala Beach in National Park, Ayala National Park, the visitors could see that 2 elephants were running like anything. They watched, but they didn't move. The humans, they didn't move. But the elephants sensed that something is about to happen wrong. That's why they all went away from the place. And the people noticed the same thing. And they ran away from the beach and or prior to the struck of tsunami. So the animals saved their life, whereas the human didn't. Another incident is also from Galle in Sri Lanka. Here there are 2 dogs refused to go to the beach for the walk. Usually they used to go for a walk, but that particular day they didn't go for a walk. So their master also could not go, and the animals saved the life of the gentleman, that is the owner of those dogs. So here I'm going to conclude that we need to keep our environment clean, else these disasters will keep occurring. So we have to save our environment. And I want to tell you people that we have to save our Mother Earth. Thank you. Have a nice day.